So after learning these features of MNCs, now we learn about the advantages. So here MNC companies, directly or indirectly, it will give lot of advantage to the home countries and host countries. So it will give the lot of advantages to the host countries and home countries. Not only advantages, it gives the disadvantages for the home country and host country. So that is what we are going to learn, what are the advantages and disadvantages for the host country and as well as for the home country. So now we'll learn about the advantages of MNCs for the host country. So what are the advantages with the MNCs to the host countries? So here MNCs, firstly, MNCs will give the increase of investment level. They will, with the introduction of MNCs, we can increase the investment level. Here investment will come to the host countries. Investment will come to the host countries. So definitely the investment level will be increasing. Not only it will give lot of employments, it will give lot of employment to the host countries, because in India most of the employment is giving, as I told earlier, most of the employment is giving by the MNC companies only. So with that, definitely with that effect, here when MNC comes to a host country, so here they will give the employment level can be increased. With the employment, that will affect with the income level also. The income level is also increased. The per capita of that individual will also increase with the giving the employment. So definitely the country's income level is also increased. So with that effect, the MNC, with the introduction of MNC, we can increase investment, employment, and not only income level of that host country. So next we'll learn about the industries. So here industries get the latest technology with the invention of MNCs. Here the host countries will get to know about the latest technology, because mostly these MNC companies are from foreign countries, which are developed countries. So they will use different, as I told, they will use sophisticated technology, and they will when they operate their business activities in the host countries, so they will bring that technology to the host country also. With that, definitely it will help. So here the industries get the latest technology. The industries get the latest technology of industries of the host country. So here whatever the industries they are locating in the host country, so they can have the sophisticated technology. That is also one of the major advantage. Next, MNCs, the host countries get the management expertise from the MNCs. Mostly MNCs people, they will recruit only specialist people, for professional people. So with that, they will get the expertised management, where they will get the local management, the local industry people. The local company will get the expertised management. So that is the benefit they will get from these MNCs. And next, domestic traders and market intermediaries gets the increased business. With the here they will get the domestic traders will be there. So here they will allocate their buying and selling to the MNCs. In the host countries, they can get more and more business with the domestic trader. Not only market intermediates are there, so they can get the increased business. They can increase their business with the effect of this MNCs. With the effect of MNCs, they can increase their business. Here domestic traders can trade their business. They can do their buying and selling in other countries also. That is the one basic advantage. And not only that, it will create the protectionism, and not only that, it will curb the local monopolies. If the company is having their monopoly in the company, so here the company is coming from other country, they can decrease the local monopolistic. And not only that, they can create the competition among the domestic domestic companies. With that, definitely that will be benefited to the consumers. When there is a good healthy competition, with that definitely it will be benefited to the consumer. Next, not only it reduces the imports, so here with the effect of, with the introduction of MNCs, they will bring technology, they will bring infrastructure facilities. With that definitely we can decrease the imports. What we are importing, because they can be made in India itself. With that definitely we can increase exports and decrease the imports. So we can increase the exports. So with that, with the introduction of MNCs, the host countries can export. They can sell into another countries also. Definitely with that, the foreign currency will come. With that, the economic development will take place. So that is how it will create the. So here with the here. The advantage to the host country will be they can reduce imports and they can increase exports. And last advantage will be industrial and economic. They can increase the industry. The host countries can increase the industrial and economic increase due to the growth of MNCs. As I told, they will bring lot of investment, infrastructure facilities, and they will invest lot of money here. With that, our investment level will be more and the employment opportunities will come. And with that, definitely it will increase the economic, industrial and economic development will take place. With that, definitely it will be developed to the host country. The host country's growth will be developed day by day. So this is what advantages of these MNCs to the host countries.